Ping's iRange of clubs has always been aimed at the better player with high swing speeds, looking for workability but also distance as well. And with the i25, Ping's new driver for 2014, better players are going to get loads of that. I'll just talk you through some of the key technological advances that have been made in this model. First of all, we've got these two tungsten weights you can see here at the back of the head, and that's going to lower the CG and move it back in the head for a more penetrating flight and better launch. The other thing we've got going on here on the crown of the club is a racing stripe. Now, this is not just for cosmetic purposes, it also has a performance benefit. What it's going to do, because it's the width of a golf ball, that's going to help you align the face, and also it's going to help you take the club away on the right path. So it's not just to look pretty, it's also going to help you play better golf, so Ping say. The other cool thing about this driver, obviously, it's now adjustable. The i20 before this was not adjustable, so you can tweak the loft via the hosel up or down a half a degree. And the last cool thing about the new i25 driver from Ping is the shafts. You now have an option of 55, 65, or 75 gram shafts, what Ping are calling PWR, so that's power, weighting, responsiveness. So you can pick whichever weight you want, but it's not going to affect the overall swing weight. So whichever club you choose, it should feel quite similar. Obviously, you know, if you're a better player looking for distance, strong flight, yeah, this is a really great club. And just to give you a little sneak preview on our driver's test, the longest shot on test was hit with an i25. I've just been having a hit with the Ping i25 driver on the range, and you know, I'm really impressed with this club. You know, when you put it behind the ball, the racing stripe, it really works. You know, it's not too big or kind of loud to dominate your focus, but I think subconsciously it really does help you aim the face and take that club away on a nice neutral path. The only thing I don't really like is the sound. It's quite loud. It's quite a loud kind of thwack. I'd prefer something a little bit quieter, but I mean, you know, that's my only qualm really. Distance was really high, and like I said before, you know, the longest shot hit in the driver's test cable in this club. So it's great that you can also, you know, fine tune your trajectory as well with the loft adjustability on the hosel. Obviously with the i20 you couldn't do that. So, you know, this is a really good driver. It's quite a low spinner, but I wouldn't say not quite as much as the Answer. So, you know, even your mid handicappers are still going to get something out of this. You know, it's easy to launch. You know, the trajectory is kind of about in the middle, maybe a fraction low. So, you know, there's a lot to like about this driver, and I think it's going to appeal to a wide range of players.